Students, this is the introduction session of the financial reporting exam for March 2020-2022 exam. So the paper is FR, that is financial reporting. And in ACC, there is a prerequisite paper of this FR, and that is called F3, the fundamental paper. And then we have FR. And then after FR, this knowledge is to be applied on the professional exam, that is the SBR. And this FR paper is entirely based on the accounting standards, that is IAS and IFRS. So first of all, let me give you the paper pattern, that how this paper comprises of. So first of all, we have section A, and section A comprises of 15 objective type questions, OTQs. Each OTQ worth 2 marks. So the entire section covers your 30 marks. The next section, which deals with the MTQs, that is the scenario based OTQ questions. So 3 MTQs having 10 marks each, and it is again worth total 30 marks. Now each MTQ comprises of 5 OTQs multiplied by 2 marks each. So this is the breakup of 1 MTQ. So it means that for 60 marks, you have to deal with the OTQs, for which no working is required. Simply, you have to identify the right answer, and these will be the numerical questions as well as the theoretical questions. The section A will be from the entire syllabus, while section B comprises of few questions from the accounting standards. Now, as far as the most important one is section C, where you have 2 questions and each question comprises of worth 20 marks. And this you have to solve on the word processing document and on Excel. So you have to use either the word processing document or the Excel will be given to you in the exam. Now, the last 2 questions are most probably being asked from what topics? One is expected question is from consolidated financial statement. And in your FR syllabus, the consolidated financial statement is based on 1 subsidiary and 1 associate. And it includes income statement as well as balance sheet. The second question might be, which is the most likely one, is ratios and interpretation of financial statement. This is a kind of a compulsory question. Third one is single company financial statement. Means you have to produce the financial statement of a single company. And these financial statement, you have to prepare from the given trial balance and with the associated adjustment related to IAS and IFRS. It means that if there is any question on single company financial statement, at least 5 to 7 IAS or IFRS adjustment will be there. So if you have a good grip on these accounting standards, you will be able to get the maximum marks from this kind of question. And it is also possible that a single question might be a mix of consolidated financial statement and ratios and interpretation, and a separate question on single company financial statement. So you can't skip any topic, assuming that this will not be examined in the March exam. So you must have a good grip on the consolidated financial statement, which is a very detailed topic. And the basics are already covered in the F3 exam. Then you have to cover this ratios and interpretation. Again, the basics have been covered in the F3 exam. And here, the most important and the most difficult part that a student face in the exam is how to write the commentary on the given ratios. A student know that how to calculate gross profit margin, the net profit margin, the current ratio, the quick ratio, the debtors turnover period. But as far as the interpretation sides are concerned, they are not able to connect the theory with the scenario. So in our session, you will be able to revise this topic. You will practice this topic in such a way that you will be able to write good commentary on it so that you can get maximum marks out of it. Now let's talk about the syllabus. What are the areas that you have to study in your syllabus and what are the core areas? So first of all, let me write the whole entire syllabus. So first topic is the consolidated financial statement. Consolidated financial statement, the group's financial statement. As I told you that in the exam, you might find one complete question on this. And in this, we have the group's income statement. We have to prepare the group's income statement and the group's statement of financial position. So in order to pass this exam, your grip on consolidated financial statement must be exceptional. The next area, that is ratio and interpretation. It's all about that you should know how to calculate each ratio and then how to comment on the changes in the ratio. For example, if I'll give you an interest coverage ratio of say, suppose 2x. So what it means, what is the definition of ratio, what it means. And if previously it was 3x, now compare with the last time, what is the reason? And you have to connect the reason with the given information. The third one is IAS and IFRS. And here we have a detail of this, that is IS2, IS1, IS2, IS7, 8, we have IS10, 12. This is the complete list of accounting standards. And we have, these are IAS and we have IFRS as well. So we have IFRS 3, we have IFRS 5, we have IFRS 10, IFRS 13, IFRS 15, IFRS 16. The core accounting standard, the most important one that you must have a good grip, especially with respect to the single company financial statement, is IS 12. IS 16, IS 38, IS 36, IAS 8, IFRS 5, IFRS 15, and IFRS 16. These are the kind of standards which examiner usually asks in the single company financial statement. And the next is IASB. Regulatory framework and conceptual framework. Now, this is the entire syllabus. And I already told you that in section C, there might be 2 or 3 questions. So in section B, you will get 3 questions. So from which area will get the question? It is not defined. So ideally, you will get these 3 questions from different accounting standards, from a mix of different accounting standards. It means what? It means in order to have passed this exam, in order to have a good grip, in order to complete the single company financial statement well, you should have or must have a good understanding of the accounting standards. And in these accounting standards, some accounting standards which you have already studied in your F3 exam, such as IS-2 inventory, IS-10 events after the reporting date, IS-16 property, plant and equipment, IS-38 intangible asset. So if you have some prior information, some prior knowledge, you can also learn or perform in a better way in the financial reporting exam. Now, as far as the resources are concerned, usually students follow the study text, that is either the Kaplan or the BBP. But if you follow my live classes, don't need to have any kind of study text with you. Just you need to have the IAS and IFRS notes, which I'll give you IAS or IFRS notes. So you have to recall those notes. You have to memorize the certain rules of the accounting standards. You don't need to have any kind of study text. And then the most important thing is the revision kit, which comprises of past papers. So we'll focus on the previous past papers and the question from the revision kit, and you'll try to solve all kind of question, that is section A, OTQs, section B, MTQs, and section C, the CB type exam, the computer-based exam, CRQs. And you will also practice these CRQs on the ACCA CBE platform so that we have an idea that how to manage time, how to use the platform. So along with our normal practice sessions, we will do some CBE platform practice as well. So this is a brief introduction of what you can expect from the examiner of FR. What is your syllabus? What is the paper pattern? What is the syllabus? Mind you, this paper is not that much difficult, but as you know that, as I already told you that the next paper is SBR. So in order to have a good understanding in SBR, in the audit paper, your financial reporting exam, the financial reporting paper preparation must be very good. So if you learn it properly from an experienced tutor in a good way, so it will help you in the audit paper of F8, SBR, as well as AAA.